The distribution of the sympathetic nervous system, we talk about it as being thoracic because the cell bodies of origin are in the intermediolateral cell column between T1 and L2, and that's pictured here. So this is about T1, and this is about L2. The sympathetic nervous system is distributed in every part of your body: head, neck, thorax, abdomen, pelvis, and your limbs, because you have blood vessels in your limbs that are going to be regulated by your sympathetics. You will also notice that we have, even though the cell bodies of origin are restricted, our ganglia are not. So we have ganglia that go all the way down here, almost into the pelvis, and we have ganglia that go all the way up into our neck, the superior cervical ganglia is all the way up right next to the bifurcation of your carotid artery from common carotid to internal and external. So what happens is these preganglionic neurons send their axons out. Sometimes they synapse at the same level. And for example, a preganglionic neuron down here around L2 could come into the cord, and then its axon could go all the way down to the last ganglia before it synapses. And so it could synapse here and then distribute. Or again, from somewhere like T1, this neuron could go all the way into the chain and go all the way up and synapse in the ganglia that is the superior cervical. So the distribution of the sympathetic chain goes beyond the distribution of the intermediolateral cell column. And that's because these axons can travel within the chain up or down a level or two, or maybe even many levels, to get to a ganglion that's eventually going to get to a more distal target. We even have a special classification for the abdominal viscera. These nerves are called splanchnic nerves, and kind of like pelvic, you'll see this term again when we talk about the parasympathetics and you think about pelvic splanchnic nerves. The sympathetic splanchnic nerves are nerves that come from areas, they're preganglionic neurons are in the intermediolateral cell column, just like all the others. And instead of synapsing in the chain, they bypass it and synapse in what we call a prevertebral ganglion. These are unpaired. You'll note that the sympathetics are paired all the way down. The prevertebrals are unpaired, and the reason they're called prevertebrals is they're more anterior. So if you draw in the vertebral bodies kind of along here, these would be in front of the spinal cord, and we can see that our sympathetic chain lies beside the bodies, and so that's para-vertebral, para beside. Prevertebral ganglia are in front, and they're down here along the aorta, and they're right next to the origins of the great vessels, the celiac trunk, the superior mesenteric artery, the inferior mesenteric artery. So those ganglia, this one's bad, I'm going to redraw this. So if I redraw my vertebral bodies, and then in front of it, kind of ghosted in front here, would be my aorta. These neurons come out, bypass the ganglia, and synapse in what is called a prevertebral ganglion. Those axons, so those come together and form the splanchnic nerves. These ganglionic neurons follow the blood vessels to get to their targets. So it's really easy to see how things in the thorax get to where they're going, because there are ribs here, and these sympathetic neurons just come out and distribute and rejoin. They rejoin the spinal nerves that are going around the edges of the ribs. The splanchnics come out, synapse in ganglia that lie along the aorta, and then instead of rejoining nerves, they actually just follow the blood vessels to all of their targets. And again, those targets are going to be abdominal targets. So everything below the diaphragm, below the ribs, so the entire digestive system, and everything also in the pelvis, all of the reproductive organs, are going to be innervated by these splanchnic nerves. And here is what the sympathetics look like in the chain. So here we have a chain ganglion. They kind of look like beads on a string. Here's the entire chain here. Here are the spinal nerves coming out and going up or down, synapsing, and then rejoining the spinal nerve here. Right here we can see the examples of some of these splanchnic nerves. So axons have come out, they've bypassed, and their axons are still going, and they're going to head down here. This is the dome of the liver. They're going to head down behind this dome of the liver, and they're going to go through the diaphragm, and then they're going to synapse in great big ganglia that lie along the aorta at the origins of the great vessels. We can also see in this image, this is the phrenic nerve, which has been pulled aside. And remember, that's part of your cervical plexus, and it's going right down to the diaphragm here, which is domed over the top of the liver. Here's our esophagus, and here's the aorta. So in summary, what do I want you to know about the sympathetic nervous system? With regard to the preganglionic sympathetic neurons, where are they found? What's their neurotransmitter? And are their axons long or short? Where will you find the sympathetic chain ganglia? And then with regard to the ganglionic neurons, where are they found? What's their neurotransmitter? And are their axons long or short? If you understand all of these concepts, you're ready for the assessment.